Hey guys, this is going to be a quick review of your lesson modifications for Unit 2, just to make sure you guys are all on the same page. Make sure you don't miss anything. So this is our lesson modification document. We should have finished Unit 1, which is the orange, so you want to go down here to blue, or sorry, Unit 5. So now we're on Unit 1, the importance of being earnest. A couple of things to note. Remember, you have your C Notes template, so you want to make sure that you look at that early. You click it. It's obviously a little off when it comes down here. Remember, you can hit the download arrow, and then it'll come up as a Word document. So you're taking quite a few notes this unit compared to last unit. So I just wanted you to be aware of everything that's there. You've got notes over irony and symbol and restoration comedy, stage directions, dialogue, Oscar Wilde, and Victorianism. So that's all there for you. Just want to make sure that you remember those. And remember, those are noted, so in purple it tells you, for example, page 3, you're taking notes on Oscar Wilde, and page 2, you've got notes over dialogue and stage direction. There's a video that I've added here on page 2 for the elements of drama, so you want to look at that instead of the strategies for reading link. Alright, so several things. Here, I've given you the first video of a set of 12 clips if you want to watch them. To supplement your reading for The Importance of Being Earnest. It's always great to see drama actually performed. So that's there. Note that sometimes I'm giving you answers in the quick checks, especially if I skip something. So you have an answer there for that quick check you'll want to look into. All right, moving on. So lesson 2, you have a replaced activity. You're going to use the Victorian web to do a little bit of research, and then you have a discussion board activity, so you want to click here and go to the discussion board. There's the Victorian web, what it looks like, and then here's the discussion board post. You are pretending that you're a character from the Victorian period, and there are some things that you have to look up. Those are all described here, and then you have to write a little brief monologue in the persona of that character and then reply to somebody's response in that same persona. So here are a few posts that have already been done. Just wanted to make sure that you knew that that was there. As we move along, there's another big change in lesson 3. I have added a portfolio grade to this assignment, to this unit. So they are 10 points each. You're going to have 3 open-ended response questions to do. Those are the EOC short answers. And you do them in our discussion board. So each one is 10 points, separate grades, 3 separate portfolio grades, 10 points each. So if you go there and go to the site, you will see, for example, here's where you do the first one. I give you 3 choices of questions. These are all akin to single selection questions. If you need some help knowing what is supposed to be in a single selection open-ended response question, our live lesson from yesterday, which was February 23rd, we spent some time going over it. We'll talk about them some more next week as well. Also on this page, you have the rubric, so you can click that and look at that and see. I'll be grading you based on this rubric. So you pick one of those questions and answer them as if it were an EOC open-ended response question. So you actually have 3 of those to do. You've got one for Act 1, you have another one for Act 2, single selection, and then you have a third one for Act 3. These will actually be treated like a combo selection, which is a different rubric. Those are the questions that ask about 2 stories, so we'll go over those next week in our live lessons, but anyway, that's towards the end. That's the end of Act 3. So those are there. You're going to treat those. They work like discussion board posts, but they're portfolio grades, so you want to make sure that you're aware of those, and the instructions are all here. Let me know if you have questions. Everything else pretty much works the same. You can see the discussion board link posts right there. And then you do have some test modifications, so you really want to make sure that you pay attention to those test modifications. So, I'll also be putting out some help videos over the importance of being earnest, so look forward to getting those. And that's pretty much it, so let me know if you have any questions. And I look forward to giving you some good feedback on those short answer responses. And remember, the reason we're doing that is in preparation for your end of course exam. So you want to take those very seriously. And I'm going to give you lots of good feedback that will help prepare you to do really well on that exam. All right, bye.